A trek through the Himalayas. The journey lasts for days and days. We trek up valley, hill and slope. We carry with ourselves the hope to traverse strange, untrodden ways. Hello students, good morning all of you. This is Sunya Thakur from Ma Kalyanika Public School. Students, today we will discuss a poem, a very nice poem. As you know that this is section 3rd of our chapter 2, last chapter of chapter 2. In this section, we have already learned about the journey. Okay, in first section 1 means we have discussed about the diary writing of 6 days. And second one, how you can complete the world around in 80 days. And this is also journey about Himalaya. Okay, the poet describes here his experience, whatever the experience he was having through the Himalayas, he has explained here. So, let's see who is the writer here. Srinjaya Chakravarti. Who is the writer? Srinjaya Chakravarti. He wants to take us the journey of Himalaya. Let's see. The journey lasts for days and days. We trek up valley, hill and slope. We carry with ourselves the hope to traverse strange, untrodden ways. Here, the poet is telling that journey of Himalaya is not easy thing to travel on the Himalayas. So he has discussed his whatever the experience. Okay, he shared here. Here he has discussed. Look at this. We means he was not alone. Okay, with him some more persons also there to travel Himalayas. He is telling that this journey lasts for days and days. Okay, they started the journey from many days and it lasts of days and days. We trek up valley, hill and slope. Okay, trek means the journey, the travel. Okay, you have known about the mountain here. Okay, the same thing, the poet also describes his feelings here. What is feeling? We trek up valley, hill and slope. Okay, they passes valleys, hills and slope, and they started their journey on the Himalayas. We carry with ourselves the hope. Okay, what is it? They were wishing that one day they must reach on the peak of the mountain, peak of the Himalaya. Fourth line is saying that we traverse strange, untrodden ways, means never seen such type of way. What is it? Traverse. Traverse means what? To travel the strange, untrodden ways. Untrodden ways means not having been worked out, means not possible on that place to work. Means it was very untrodden, means not possible to work. He is mentioning in this danger that he started, means with his friends, they started their journey to Himalaya from days. Started from many days and it lasts for days by days. And they passes through the valleys, hills and slope. And we carry with ourselves the hope. Means one day they must reach, they wish like that. One day they must reach on the peak of the mountain. Might be the way is untrodden. Means not possible to walk. Okay, we will see now the second. Now we will see the second stanza. We enter now a world of clouds. Along the way, we hear the call of mountain and wind and waterfall. The valley mist is spreading clouds. What he is telling here in second stanza? We enter now a world of clouds. In first stanza, we knew that he started climbing the mountain and it was untrodden ways. In day, after some time, what happened? We enter now a world of clouds. When you go up, that time it seems like that the clouds is over your head only. Okay, clouds over your head only. So they entered the world of clouds. What they have seen here? They have seen along the way we hear the call, okay, of mountain wind and waterfall. Means the sound of the waterfall and the sound of the hill means whatever the wind passing through the mountain and hill, it makes a beautiful sound, and it was making beautiful with the sound of the waterfall there. Now he is telling the pellet. Look at this. The pellet means the spreading clouds. Means the mist everywhere. The mist covered means covered the clouds. Means all the hills, all the mountains, whatever they passed on their way. Okay, everywhere the light mist spreading clouds means the beautiful mist covered all the way, and it was showing beautiful and giving them energy to go up. In third stanza we will see. In the third stanza, at last we reach the final peak. The summit beckons us to come. The air is cold, our feet are numb. We climb to reach the grail we seek. Here in fourth stanza they started moving upwards to the peak. Okay, second stanza, what happened? After passing the untrodden place, they reached there. In the third stanza, he is telling them, at last we reach the final peak, means at last the destination came, and they reached on the final peak. What happened there? See, there the summit beckons us to come, means whatever the friends he was having, the boy was having, anyone is going off, anyone is behind of the boy, that time they come closer. Okay, means the boy is telling them, they were showing them to come here, come fast, to come closer to us. Means that the summit becomes us to come. Next, he is telling, the air is cold, our feet are numb. Means, you know that on the Himalayas, what is happening there? Means too much cold air passing, and they were telling that when they reached the goal, means when they reached on the peak, that time what happened? Their feet are numb. Numb means, here it is again, not having feeling. They were feeling like that, they were not having their feet. Okay, because of too much cold air. Okay. Then we climb to reach the grail we seek. Okay. Then also, after that also, they think that whatever they desire, the place, whatever the place they had to seek, they should reach there. If any kind of difficulties comes on their way, that time also they will pass all the difficulties and they will reach their destination. What he is saying? We grail we seek means whatever the target we seek. Seek means desire. Means they wish to reach there. They should reach on their target. And it is telling that we glad to reach the grail we seek. Here once again I am telling, at last we reach the final peak. The summit beckons us to come. The air is cold, our feet are numb. We glad to reach the grail we seek. No doubt we are having many difficulties. Then also we just go on and go on. Means they didn't take any kind of rest there. Means after feeling that their feet were numb, then also they started moving to one place to another place. They were passing one mountain to another mountain to seek their destination, to reach their destination, whatever the target they were having. In the fourth number stanza, now students, look at the fourth stanza. Here it is telling that the path is steep and narrow there. It snakes its way. These stairs of stone, then now mark the route we make our own. The sunshine gilds the naked air. Here the point is telling that they passed all the way, they reached on the peak. That time they saw that everywhere covered with the mist and looking very nice. It shows that here it is telling, now the path is steep and narrow there. Whatever the path will be means steep. Steep means, what is the steep? What is the meaning of steep? Rising and falling. Okay, the path is not clear. The path is whatever rising and falling also. That is called steep. And narrow layer means not wide. Then it snakes its way these stairs of stone. Okay? It snakes. Snakes means not straight. Not straight. And everywhere, each every path means the poet describes his experiences when he was passing through that way. He found that on each and every step they found the stairs of stones. After that he is saying, no marked route we make our own. Okay, after he is telling that now we have to mark our own way, means own path. Means you know that why he is telling so? Before many mountaineers, okay, went to the Himalaya on the same way and it was showing many paths, but now the poet is telling that we will not follow anybody's path, anybody's way. We will mark our own path there. And he is telling about the sunshine gives the lucid air, means which path we will find out, where everywhere it spreads with brightness, spreads with light of the sunshine, where it is looking like that, where the sky and means the earth and sky will meet together. Okay, it is showing like that, means he is saying that when they found sunshine is reaching there also, on the peak also, but still they are feeling they are cold, and that's why their feet were also numb. And he is telling that how beautiful the scene on that peak, how what type of scenery. He is telling that the sunshine gives the lucid air, means the sunshine bathes the air and seems golden. Okay, everywhere it seems golden and the beautiful scenery. And they thought that they reached, now they are getting light. Means whatever the things they had before, now they were going through brightness. Okay, they are passing one step by another step to reach the peak. And in the last stanza, it's very much interesting. He explained what is the last stanza. See, now look at the last stanza. What the poet is saying? The peak is stuck with gaining snow. The peak is stuck with gaining snow. We look where sky and earth have merged. Then from high above, our souls are purged. From high above, our souls are purged. Then forgotten lies the world below. Very interesting. He is explaining here that when they reached on the peak of the mountain, peak of the Himalayas, what happened here? He is saying the peak is stuck with gelid snow. Okay, I have mentioned before, it was covered with mist and everywhere looking golden with the sunshine. And he is mentioning here gelid snow means extremely cold. Everywhere it was spread with snow and it was looking like golden with the sunshine. But still, they were feeling extremely cold. And he is saying, we look where sky and earth have merged. It is looking like that, where sky and earth have merged there. Means where the sky and earth meet together. Okay, from high above our soul are birds. Okay, forgotten lies the world below. Means he is mentioning that after reaching, what happened there? After reaching, what were the difficulties they passed when they started the journey? That time, after reaching, everything they forgotten. Okay, they have forgotten everything and now their soul is extremely cleansed. Okay, soul extremely cleansed. Purged means cleansed of bad thought and feelings. Cleansed means purged means cleansed of bad thought and feelings. Means whatever the bad deeds they have done before. Okay, all the things now cleansed. Means now their soul is cleansed with every forgotten. Means now they are having the good soul. Okay? Means he has befriended after reaching the destination, after getting enlightenment. Okay? Here enlightenment is called means after the bad thoughts they meet in the light. Means everywhere it is spreading good scenery. How beautiful the place is, and it is the mountain peak, means the Himalaya peak. Now they reach there and they are feeling like they have got light. Means every gifts they forgot, and now they are thankful near God. They reach their destination. Students, in this poem, the poet who was the poet I have mentioned. Yes, students, at last I hope that you have learned many things through this poem. Okay, this poem is related throughout our life. You know that first we take birth, then till the destination, till the last time of our life. Okay, we struggle only. Means whatever difficulties, one by one, the path we will pass, and many difficulties comes to our life. Yes, that time what happened? We didn't deny to pass that way. Okay, we think there to pass, how to pass that way, the difficulties, the things like that. The poet also here mentioned that when they started journey, that time it was full of difficulties. Okay, stony ways, windy mountains. Okay, and they heard the sounds of the only fountains. Nobody was there, and they were looking their path. Means before whoever went there, they saw their path also, but they didn't copy their path. Means didn't follow their path, and they made their own path, and at last they reached the goal. It seems that the story is related to our whole journey of our life to death. Okay, the poet also describes like that and tried to relate this poem with our life. Students, I hope you all have understood, and in the next video I will bring another chapter for you. Thank you.